Daily Evening Prayer, Tuesday, January 23rd, 2024. Nations shall come to your light, and kings to the brightness of your rising. Let us humbly confess our sins to Almighty God. Almighty and most merciful Father, we have erred and strayed from your ways like lost sheep. We have followed too much the devices and desires of our own hearts. We have offended against your holy laws. We have left undone those things which we ought to have done, and we have done those things which we ought not to have done. And apart from your grace, there is no hope in us. O Lord, have mercy upon us. Spare all those who confess your faults. Restore all those who are penitent, according to your promises, and declare to all people, in Christ Jesus our Lord. And grant, O most merciful Father, for his sake, that we may now live a godly, righteous, and sober life, to the glory of your holy name. Amen. Grant to your faithful people, merciful Lord, pardon and peace, that we may be cleansed from all our sins and serve you with a quiet mind. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. O Lord, open our lips, and our mouths shall proclaim your praise. O God, make speed to save us. O Lord, make haste to help us. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. Praise the Lord. The Lord's name be praised. O gladsome light, pure brightness of the ever-living Father in heaven, O Jesus Christ, holy and blessed, now as we come to the setting of the sun, and our eyes behold the vesper light, we sing your praises, O God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. You are worthy at all times to be praised by happy voices, O Son of God, O Giver of life, and to be glorified through all the worlds. When Israel came out of Egypt, and the house of Jacob from among a people of a foreign tongue, Judah was God's sanctuary, and Israel his dominion. The sea beheld it and fled. Jordan was driven back. The mountains skipped like rams and the little hills like young sheep. What ailed you, O sea that you fled? O Jordan that you were driven back? You mountains that you skipped like rams and you little hills like young sheep. Tremble, O earth, at the presence of the Lord, at the presence of the God of Jacob. Who turned the hard rock into a pool of water, and the flint stone into a springing well. Not unto us, O Lord, not unto us, but unto your name give the praise, for your loving mercy and for your truth's sake. Why shall the nations say, where now is their God? As for our God, he is in heaven. He has done whatsoever pleased him. Their idols are silver and gold, even the work of human hands. They have mouths, but they speak not. Eyes have they, but they see not. They have ears, but they hear not. Noses have they, but they smell not. They have hands, but they feel not. Feet have they, but they walk not. Neither is there any sound in their throat. Those who make them are like them, and so are all who put their trust in them. But you, O house of Israel, trust in the Lord. He is their helper and defender. You, house of Aaron, put your trust in the Lord. He is their helper and defender. You who fear the Lord, put your trust in the Lord. He is their helper and defender. The Lord has been mindful of us, and he shall bless us. He shall bless the house of Israel. He shall bless the house of Aaron. He shall bless those who fear the Lord, both small and great together. The Lord shall increase you more and more, you and your children after you. You are the blessed of the Lord who has made heaven and earth. The heavens are the Lord's, the earth has he given to the children of men. The dead praise you not, O Lord, neither all those who go down into silence. But we will praise the Lord from this time forth forevermore. Praise the Lord. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be. World without end. Amen. A reading from the book of Jeremiah, beginning with the 22nd chapter, the first verse. This is what the Lord says: Go down to the house of the king of Judah and speak this word and say, Hear the word of the Lord, O king of Judah, who sits on David's throne, you and your servants and your people who enter these gates. This is what the Lord says: Do justice and righteousness, and save one who has been robbed from the power of his oppressor, and do not mistreat or do violence to the stranger, the orphan, or the widow, and do not shed innocent blood in this place. For if you will indeed perform this instruction, then kings will enter the gates from this house, sitting in David's place, on his throne, riding in chariots and on horses, the king himself, his servants, and his people. But if you will not obey these words, I swear by myself, declares the Lord, that this house will become a place of ruins. For this is what the Lord says concerning the house of the king of Judah. You are like Gilead to me, like the summit of Lebanon. Yet most assuredly I will make you a wilderness, cities that are not inhabited. For I will set apart destroyers against you, each with his weapons, and they will cut down your choicest cedars and throw them on the fire. Many nations will pass by the city, and they will say to one another, Why has the Lord done this to this great city? Then they will answer, Because they abandoned the covenant of the Lord their God and bowed down to other gods and served them. Do not weep for the dead or mourn for him, but weep deeply for the one who goes away, for he will never return or see his native land. For this is what the Lord says regarding Shallum, the son of Josiah, king of Judah, who became king in the place of his father Josiah, who went out from his place. He will never return here, but in the place where he took him into exile, there he will die, and he will not see this land again. Woe to him who builds this house without righteousness, and his upstairs room without justice, who uses his neighbor's services without pay and does not give him his wages, who says, I will build myself a large house with spacious upstairs rooms and cut out its windows, paneling it with cedar and painting it bright red. Did you become a king because you are competing in cedar? Did your father not eat and drink and do justice and righteousness? Then it was well for him. Plead the cause of the afflicted and the poor, then it was than it was well. Is that not what it means to know me? Blessed the Lord. But your eyes and your heart are intent only upon your own dishonest gain and on shedding innocent blood and on practicing oppression and extortion. Therefore, this is what the Lord says regarding Jehoiakim, the son of Josiah, king of Judah. They will not mourn for him, O my brother, or O sister. They will not mourn for him, O for the master, or O for his splendor. He will be buried with a donkey's burial, dragged off and thrown out beyond the gates of Jerusalem. Go up to Lebanon and cry out, and raise your voice in Bashan. Cry out also from Abarim. For all your lovers have been crushed. I spoke to you in your prosperity, but you said, I will not listen. This has been your way from your youth, that you have not obeyed my voice. The wind will sweep away all your shepherds, and your lovers will go into captivity. Then you will certainly be ashamed and humiliated because of all your wickedness. You who lived in Lebanon, nested in the cedars, how will you groan when sharp pains come on you, pain like a woman in childbirth? As I live, declares the Lord, even if Coniah, the son of Jehoiakim, king of Judah, were a signet ring on my right hand, yet I will pull it you off, and I will hand you over to those who are seeking your life, yes, to those of whom you are frightened, that is, to Nebuchadnezzar, king of Babylon, and the Chaldeans. I will hurl you and your mother who gave birth to you into another country where you were not born, and there you will die. But as for the land to which they long to return, they will not receive it. Is this man, Konya, a despised, shattered jar, or is he an undesirable vessel? Why have he and his descendants been hurled out and cast into a land that they had not known? O land, 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 hear the word of the Lord. This is what the Lord says. Write this man down as childless, a man who will not prosper in his days. For no man among his descendants shall prosper. For no man among his descendants will prosper, sitting on the throne of David or ruling again in Judah. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Seek the Lord while he wills to be found. Call upon him when he draws near. Let the wicked forsake their ways and the evil ones their thoughts. And let them turn to the Lord, and he will have compassion, and to our God, for he will richly pardon. For my thoughts are not your thoughts, nor your ways my ways, says the Lord. For as the heavens are higher than the earth, so are my ways higher than your ways, and my thoughts than your thoughts. For as rain and snow fall from the heavens and return not again, but water the earth, bringing forth life and giving growth, seed for sowing and bread for eating, so is my word that goes forth from my mouth. It will not return to me empty, but it will accomplish that which I have purposed, and prosper in that for which I sent it. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. A reading from St. Paul's first epistle to the Corinthians, beginning with the 7th chapter, the first verse. Now concerning the things about which you wrote, it is good for a man not to touch a woman, but because of sexual immoralities, each man is to have his own wife, and each woman is to have her own husband. The husband must fulfill his duty to his wife, and likewise the wife also to her husband. The wife does not have authority over her own body, but the husband does, and likewise the husband also does not have authority over his own body, but the wife does. Stop depriving one another, except by agreement for a time, so that you may devote yourselves to prayer, and come together again, so that Satan will not tempt you because of your lack of self-control. But this I say by way of concession, not of command. Yet I wish that all men were even as I myself am. However, each has his own gift from God, one in this way and another in that. But I say to the unmarried and to widows that it is good for them if they remain But I say to the unmarried and to the widows that it is good for them if they remain even as I. But if they do not have self-control, let them marry, for it is better to marry than to burn with passion. But to the married I give instructions, not I, but the Lord, that the wife is not to leave her husband. But if she does leave, she must remain unmarried, or else be reconciled to her husband, and that the husband is not to divorce his wife. But to the rest I say, not the Lord, that if any brother has an unbelieving wife, and she consents to live with him, he must not divorce her. And if any woman has an unbelieving husband, and he consents to live with her, she must not divorce her husband. For the unbelieving husband is sanctified through his wife, and the unbelieving wife is sanctified through her believing husband. For otherwise your children are unclean, but now they are holy. Yet if the unbelieving one is leaving, let him leave. The brother or sister is not under bondage in such cases, but God has called us in peace. For how do you know, wife, whether you will save your husband? Or how do you know, husband, whether you will save your wife? Only as the Lord has assigned to each one, as God has called each, in this way let him walk. And so I direct in all the churches. Was any man called when he was already circumcised? Is he not to become uncircumcised? Was any man called when he was already circumcised? He is not to become uncircumcised. Has anyone being called in uncircumcision, he is not to be circumcised. Circumcision is nothing, and uncircumcision is nothing, but what matches is the keeping of the commandments of God. Each person is to remain in that state in which he was called. Were you called as a slave? Do not let it concern you. But if you are also able to become free, take advantage of that. For the one who was called in the Lord as a slave is the Lord's free person. For the one who is called in the Lord as a slave is the Lord's freed person. Likewise, the one who was called as free is Christ's slave. You were bought for a price. Do not become slaves of people. Brothers and sisters, each one is to remain with God in that condition in which he was called. Now concerning virgins, I have no command of the Lord, but I am offering direction as one who, by the mercy of the Lord, is trustworthy. I think then that this is good in view of the present distress, that it is good for a man to remain as he is. Are you bound to a wife? Do not seek to be released. Are you released from a wife? Do not seek a wife. But if you marry, you have not sinned, and if a virgin marries, she has not sinned. Yet such people as yourselves will have trouble in this life, and I am trying to spare you. This I say, brothers, the time has been shortened so that from now on those who have wives should be as though they had none, and those who weep as though they did not weep, and those who rejoice as though they did not rejoice, and those who buy as though they did not possess, and those who use the world as though they did not make full use of it. For the present form of this world is passing away. But I want you to be free from concern. One who is unmarried is concerned about the things of the Lord, how he may please the Lord. But one who is married is concerned about the things of the world, how he may please his wife, and his interests are divided. The woman who is unmarried and the virgin is concerned about the things of the Lord, but that she may be holy both in body and spirit. But one who is married is concerned about the things of the world, how she may please her husband. I say this for your own benefit, not to put a restraint on you, but to promote what is appropriate and to secure undistracted devotion to the Lord. But if anyone thinks that he is acting dishonorably toward his virgin, if she is past her youth, and it ought to be so, let him do what he wishes. He is not sinning. Let them marry. But the one who stands firm in his heart, if he is not under constraint but has authority over his own will and has decided this in his own heart to keep his own virgin, he will do well. So then, both the one who gives his own virgin in marriage does well, and the one who does not give her in marriage will do better. A wife is bound as long as her husband lives, but if her husband dies, she is free to marry. She is free to be married to whom she wishes, only in the Lord. But in my opinion, she is happier if she remains as she is. And I think that I also have the Spirit of God. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. My soul magnifies the Lord, and my spirit rejoices in God my Savior, for he has regarded the lowliness of his handmaiden. For behold, from now on all generations will call me blessed, for he that is mighty has magnified me, and holy is his name, and his mercy is on those who fear him throughout all generations. He has shown the strength of his arm. He has scattered the proud in the imagination of their hearts. He has brought them, he has brought down the mighty from their thrones and has exalted the humble and meek. He has filled the hungry with good things, and the rich he has sent empty away. He, remembering his mercy, has helped his servant Israel, as he promised to our father Abraham. Let his seed forever. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day, he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. The Lord be with you and with your spirit. Let us pray. Lord, have mercy upon us. Christ, have mercy upon us. Lord, have mercy upon us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. That this evening may be holy, good, and peaceful, we entreat you, Lord, that your holy angels may lead us in paths of peace and goodwill, we entreat you, Lord, that we may be pardoned and forgiven for our sins and offenses, we entreat you, Lord, that there may be peace in your church and in the whole world, we entreat you, Lord, that we may depart this life in your faith and fear, and not be condemned before the great judgment seat of Christ, we entreat you, Lord. Give us grace, O Lord, to answer readily the call of our Savior Jesus Christ and proclaim to all people the good news of his salvation, that we and the whole world may perceive the glory of his marvelous works, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. Lighten our darkness, we beseech you, O Lord, and by your great mercy defend us from all perils and dangers of this night. For the love of your only Son, our Savior Jesus Christ. Amen. O God, you manifest in your servants the signs of your presence. Send forth upon us the spirit of love, that in companionship with one another, your abounding grace may increase among us. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Almighty God, Father of all mercies, we, your unworthy servants, give you humble thanks for all your goodness and loving kindness to us and to all whom you have made. We bless you for our creation, preservation, and all the blessings of this life, but above all for your immeasurable love and the redemption of the world by our Lord Jesus Christ, for the means of grace and for the hope of glory. And we pray, give us such an awareness of your mercies that with truly thankful hearts we may show forth your praise, not only with our lips, but in our lives, by giving up ourselves to your service, and by walking before you in holiness and righteousness all our days, through Jesus Christ our Lord, to whom with you and the Holy Spirit be honor and glory throughout all ages. Amen. Almighty God, you have given us grace at this time with one accord to make our promise obligations to you. And you have promised through your well-beloved Son that when two or three are gathered together in his name, you will grant our requests. Fulfill now, Lord, our desires and petitions as we request for us, granting us in this world knowledge of your truth and the age to come, life everlasting. Let us bless the Lord. Thanks be to God. Glory to God, whose power working in us can do infinitely more than we can ask or imagine. Glory to him from generation to generation in the church and in Christ Jesus forever and ever. Amen.